Good evening, good afternoon. Welcome to the G-Lew Show Podcast, episode 11. And this evening we have a very special guest. We have the talented, young, beautiful, and legendary, living legend, Miss Tiffany Simmons of Simmons Law, located in Atlanta, Georgia. But she is worldwide. And she is live on our podcast this evening for episode 11. So we want to welcome Tiffany to the show. Good afternoon. Good evening, Tiffany.
Good evening. Good evening. Good evening, everybody. Thanks for having me again on the show.
Oh, yeah. It's only right. We had to bring you back. You've been on the show before, but never on the podcast. So, you know, the podcast is a bit different. So, we definitely had to bring you back. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah.
So what's going on with you, Tiff? I know you're doing a little traveling right now. You're kind of moving around. What's going on with you right now?
Yeah, well, I'm back in Atlanta now, but I just got back from New York. If anyone watches shows like where you watch the trials, murder trials, or, you know, the live courtrooms, I've been appearing on a show called Law and Crime, which is based out of New York. Now, I've been appearing the past couple months from Atlanta. However, this past week, I was the in-studio guest on the show. So, yes, I was up in New York shooting it up there with them, had a great time talking about some of the latest murder trials that's going on. There's some new stuff going on.
Okay, definitely some new stuff since last time we talked to you. Tell me how the transition has been like from you just being in court, you know, doing your thing locally or whatever you do, to now traveling and appearing on shows like going to Hollywood now. How has that transition been? Or how did it come about?
It's not really a transition because this is something I always knew I was going to do and stuff that I have been doing. Even right. On this level, it's just we're in a world of taking pictures and social media where things are documented differently. For example, I used to do CNN, HLN After Dark. Those are stations where they had, like, shows based on, like I said, court watching or the latest trials that are going on. I've been doing this, like, 8-9 years ago. So it's not anything mm-hmm. new. It's just an extension of myself as the entertainer slash attorney. So, you know, it's just more growing more into, you know, Tiffany, the plug lawyer, the brand, more so than just
right.
being the attorney. Some of the things
right,
that,
right.
you know, I know is coming soon is me doing a judge show. So, again, it's an extension of me as the lawyer educating our community through entertaining.
Right. And now, being with that being said, when can we expect somewhat of a maybe your own show? Because I know that has to be coming soon or in the future, where you kind of do this on your own or have guests of your own.
I do a lot of that kind of sort of when I have my IG lives. I've been doing probably for the last month now on Sunday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern time. I've been doing these talks with Tiffany, and I ask people to submit their legal questions. They have them, and they've been coming on. And the blessing with that is I really just did it because, you know, I'm one of them people that's kind of like a popular loner. I'm well known, but I am one of those people that kind of protects my energy as well. So me doing the lives, that was a way for, you know, my audience to kind of get to know me, ask legal questions in a setting where, you know, I'm inviting you into my house. So all my internet cousins come over on Sunday nights and kick it with me. So that's something I'm doing right now. As far as a judge show, that is in the works. So be on the lookout for that for 2020. So it's a lot more
right.
of Tiffany the Entertainer for 2020.
Right. And I want to piggyback off of what you just said. You said you're popular loner, you know, which I can understand. But how do you, being that you're a popular loner, how do you get all these things done that you do? You know what I mean? You're always moving. You're always working. You're doing so much. kind of by yourself. I'm sure maybe you have a team that you work with that you always have, but how do you get so many things done, you know, by yourself this way?
Well, I don't do everything by myself. You're right. There is a team that assists me. In addition to that, I do the things that I feel is related to my purpose. So it doesn't feel like work. It doesn't feel like something that's stressful. Of course, things don't always go as planned per se, but one of the things that I am learning is to make sure you go on with the flow of life and not really trying to force stuff. When you go on with the flow of life, things happen naturally. Things happen in sync. Things happen, you know, that's on purpose.
Right.
So a lot of the things that I do, it may seem like a lot to the people that's not doing a lot. you can either be a talker or a doer, but, you know,
right.
I'm just a person that's a doer.
That part. And I want to ask you this, not only just for the people, but personally, I want to ask you, where do you get the energy to do everything you do, the spirit, the high spirit you have, the great, you know, energy that, because you, like I said again, you're always doing something, you're always moving, you're always working, and you find time to do other things, community service, help other people, you know, be a family person, you know, so many things you do. How do you keep up that energy and that drive, you know, to do all these things when I know you don't have to do them all, you know?
Well, I think that when you're doing things that you like to do, when you're doing things that you love and you appreciate this life, you know, it's not that hard. It just comes from appreciation of life. I've lost a lot of people, or not even lost. Just people have transitioned in life that I've known, that I've loved. People I didn't know personally that I love. I mean, rest in peace, Kobe. Rest in peace to a lot of the entertainers that we know that are dying or died and have transitioned. And looking at those experiences, I always look at it as, okay, God, if you still have me here waking up, I'm going to make the best of it because there is something that I need to leave here on this earth for the next generation. And, you know, just to be right. real with you, part of it is because God hasn't blessed me with children yet. So a lot of my projects, a lot of the things that I'm involved in, community service or be it with my godkids or nieces and nephews or the stuff I do with my law firm, it's because this is the time for me to give that energy because I'm not a parent yet where I have to give all that devotion to my children and my partner and my family unit, you know, my personal family unit,
right.
if that makes sense.
Right. Yeah, it does. It makes perfect sense. And speaking on that, I want to ask you, when will it or will ever do you think about maybe having kids or even because you have to settle down first to even do that or maybe you don't? You know, is there a time you plan to do that in the near future?
Well,
not in the near
like
future, but in the future
like
period.
You know, we always make plans, but God laughs at our plans and life laughs at our plans. Yeah, they're I do want to have children and you know, raise them with a partner. And who knows, that might be soon. It we'll see. I just have to
right.
keep living and keep loving and the rest will fall into place.
Right. But being that just, you know, that you're so busy and work a lot, have you, how can I say this? Has it become a point in your life where still that will have to kind of fit in, not fit in if the perfect person comes or if that happens as God makes it, you will make it happen. But being that you do so much, it's going to, you know, I'm sure your partner or whoever you deal with will have to understand or know what you do. And even that will have to make time for you because you do so much. And now this comes into play. How will you know to separate the two? And now, okay, something's coming in my life. Will that slow you down? Because I know it won't.
I don't feel like it'll be a slowdown of anything. I feel like it'll be just a natural extension of my life. I mean, everybody evolves. Everybody experiences more as they grow as a person. So it'll just be a natural extension of my life. As far as a person, I guess, fitting in with my life or, you know, Me having children, that's not something that I would take lightly, because if it did, you know, I probably would have been in situations where I was a parent now or whatever. So, you know, I say that to say it's going to be the right fit when it does happen. And I'm going to be ready. Right. You know, he'll be ready and we'll be ready. But until
that's
then,
right.
I'm going to keep having fun and living my life.
That's right. That's right. Before we continue, because we moved ahead, we're talking about a lot, but I want to let you give the people just a backdrop, because we just jumped into you being a lawyer and doing all these incredible things that you do and working so much. But, you know, you've been on the show before, but not on this podcast. So this is a whole gang of new listeners and people that will be listening. So give the people just a backdrop about Tiffany Simmons, Simmons Law, and what you do and everything, how you came to do it.
Well, Simmons Law, we are a law business of this generation based in Atlanta, Georgia. I've had my legal practice for 10 years, so a decade in this thing, undefeated attorney. I have beat every case that I have taken to trial over the last 10 years. So we out here.
Still undefeated.
The firm.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. The firm is a firm that I personally do business, criminal defense, and entertainment law. This year, 2020, we are putting our main focus into our personal injury side of the firm and our personal injury clients. So if you are injured, if you are in a car accident, injured at a restaurant, or any of those things, hit us up, 404-461-8422. You can follow us. Most of our updates are on our Instagram page, which is Official Simmons Law. We have Twitter, I Am Simmons Law. We have our YouTube channel, where I'm always uploading videos that gives free legal information, as well as some blog videos. You can see the life of the plug lawyer, and that's on Instagram, just Tiffany Simmons.
That part. And you spoke about the personal injury thing. I'm glad you did, because I spoke to you about that last time briefly. But that has really become a big, I don't want to say big business, but a big part of everything. And a lot of lawyers, like I told you before, I hear a lot of commercials and a lot of things of that sort, especially in Atlanta, about personal injury, people, you know, car accidents or whatever it may be. So like you said, in 2020, you're going into more of that. Is that something that has, like I said, it's just more needs more attention, you know what I mean? Or more, you know, that made you want to get in more into personal injury?
I don't believe it's an area that needs more attention. However, it's an area that we chose to focus on this year just due to the progression of our firm. A lot of people hear about personal injury firms because you do hear the commercials in the ways that personal injury firms market. But the thing with Simmons Law, we are a firm of integrity. People know my name. People know my brand. So you can trust me as your personal injury attorney, as opposed to just hearing a jingle or seeing a billboard. And nothing against any method of advertising or marketing, but we're not a firm that's just trying to run your case through the mill. We're going to put in the work. We're going to do our very best to get the policy limits if there's a settlement. And then you have an attorney that has never lost a trial. I'm undefeated in all my trials. So if we take this case to trial, you're going to get a great verdict. And I'm not going to say guarantee, because I never guarantee that, but I guarantee that I will do my very best, which is always great. But yeah,
right,
we actually just settled a case. A client was injured at a local Atlanta restaurant. We settled her case for $55,000. She ended up with a scar on her forearm. And yeah, we were able to get our client $55,000 from that settlement.
Okay, that's what's up. And being that you are undefeated and you've been doing this so long, how do you go about taking on cases? Do you take on cases mainly, you know, like if you know, not know, because you never know if you can win, but do you basically take on cases that only, you know, like serious cases that you pretty much think you will, you know, come out, you know, where you can win, or the person has a case, or do you sometimes take on cases you know, on a personal basis or just trying to help somebody, you know, because you never know if you can win. So how do you go about taking on your cases?
Okay. Well, case evaluations definitely is a case-by-case situation where we take a look at the facts of the case. It's not anything where I say, oh, is this a win or a lose situation, because that's not how I go into a case. I go into a situation looking at that client and their circumstances and looking at, is Simmons Law the best fit for this client? Is this client the best fit for Simmons Law? And if it's the best fit, everything is going to fall into place. But if this client is not a best fit for us, then we'll gladly refer them to someone else that can assist them or let them know what we can do. So it's not a thought process of a win-lose type of situation, because Simmons Law, one right. thing about it, you know, Simmons Law, I do everything based out of love, whether that's correcting your ass, whether that's speaking for you, whether that's allowing you to retain my services, whether that's, you know, speaking life into you at an event, whatever, it's done from a good space. So, you know, the evaluating of a case, that's done a little bit different than some other firms may do their evaluations.
Right. And have you ever worked on a case where, like you said, you were dealing with a client or whatever, and you had to, during the case or before the case, or you know, where you had to think maybe this is not the right fit, you had to dismiss your client or stop, you know, have things happen along that nature where, you know, situations come up where you can't work with the client any further?
Yes, of course. That has okay. happened. And that's happened, you know, on more than one occasion. And that's some of the things that you learn as a seasoned attorney. You find out what is a perfect fit or a good fit for you and your firm and your team, and what is not a good fit. You know, most people, they, for example, I had a meeting with a local millionaire here in Atlanta, and we were looking to do some work together. And after that meeting, I decided that it wasn't the best fit for Simmons Law to do that. Now, most people would look at that, oh, this is a millionaire, a chance for me to work with them, and blah, 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 and all of the things that people look at as attractive, per se. But for me, it just wasn't a good fit. I don't care if you're a millionaire or a trillionaire, or you could be Jesus' brother. If you're not a good fit, you're just not a good fit. And I have to stand on that decision. So, like I say, there has been times like that, and we just have to do what's best for business. It's nothing personal.
Right. And being that I'm sure you work with a lot of clients, I don't know, in the entertainment business, regular people, like you said, just regular millionaires, business people, who are some of the memorable clients that you've worked with or that you were proud to work with that you won cases for or just dealt with, period, that was a good experience for you, if any?
There has been, but honestly, I'm not one of those people that like to name drop, so
okay.
I really
okay.
don't want to do that.
Okay.
But what I will
you.
Do is, in the sake of keeping someone's memory alive, I will give a shout out to rest in peace, long live Bankroll Fresh. And he was a memorable client because I actually got to do a little bit of legal work for him right before he transitioned. And, you know, I just want to shout him out because his team just put out his mixtape after 4 years of him, you know, passing or whatever. So I'll say that that is one that is memorable that I will shout out. And, you know, that's just because you know, they just put out a mixtape in his memory. So shout out to Bankroll Fresh, you know, a.k.a. Trent, because, of course, I knew the legal name.
right. Bankroll Fresh, rest in peace. I know you do a lot of traveling. You just came from New York. How was your travels? Do you get to mix some fun in with your work? Because I know you're in New York. Did you get to have a little fun and let your hair down while you were there, or was it all work?
Yeah, it was both work and fun. Like I say, anything I do is going to be fun to me. So as soon as I walked in the studio, you know, the plug's lawyer was in the building, and it was all fun.
Right.
So that was, of course, fun to me. I have friends up there as well. So, yeah, I kicked it in New York when I was there. But, you know, if I'm in business mode, you know, I'll handle the business and then I'll get back to the fun. Yeah.
Right, right. And let's talk about this fun side. You know, this is the podcast, Raw and Uncut. You know, you do like to have a lot of fun. As you see, people probably see and follow you and see, again, that you're not your just average female lawyer. You know what I mean? You have a lot of different, what can I say? Things about yourself that make you unique, and people love that about you. I'm sure even people in the legal field, you know, find that, you know, that they like you when they meet you or see the different sides of you and how you like to have fun. What does Tiffany like to do to have fun? Being that you do all this work and you're a serious attorney and all of this, what's that fun side like of Tiffany?
I think you see the fun side throughout, you know, me, whatever I'm doing, to be honest. So, you know, it's not never really just a serious lawyer. I'm serious about my brand and my business, I guess. Things I like to do for fun. I mean, if you look at our YouTube channel, you definitely can catch me on there painting. You can catch me on there fishing. I do like to fish. I'm a girl that likes to, you know, do tomboyish shit sometimes. So I'll go fishing. You will catch me at the strip club. I mean, you will catch me with the Atlanta car club community. Just recently, I joined a car club. I love fast cars. I drive a fast car, so I joined a car club called the Gassed Up Maniacs. So we just had a meet today. So, you know, I'm out there in the street. I like to do things that, you know, give you an adrenaline rush, I guess.
Right, right. And how was that modeling thing going? I know you were starting to model a bit, and we see you modeling, you know, all these pictures and everything. How is that going for you?
It's going great. If you look at my or follow my Instagram, The Pretty Bully, that's my acting modeling page. Again, just an extension of myself. I was doing modeling pictures when I was a baby. So, again, this is stuff that I've done all of my life. However, I'm just exposing it more and more to the world.
Right. Right. And you spoke about acting, so we can expect you to maybe do some acting in the future as well?
Yes, you've seen me on stuff already. If you Netflix and chill, you can catch me on the Netflix movie The Trap with T.I., Mike Epps, DC Young Fly, Duval. If you watch TV, you can catch me on Paternity Court, Couples Court. You can catch me on the show Titan Games. You can catch me in some of your music videos. Most recently, I'm in a music video for Lil Baby and Schoolie. I'm in a music video for Juicy Fruit and Rico Nasty. Those are recent videos. But, yeah, like I say, all of this stuff is nothing new, but we just live in a world where people want to see it, to believe it on social media. So we definitely update the social media as much as we can. But again, cream's going to rise to the top. So when I'm on bigger and bigger platforms, as you'll see, people will say, oh, you know, where'd she come from? Nah, this ain't an overnight celebrity. You know how people say it takes at least 10 years to, you know, I guess make it overnight. Like I say, I'm a decade in law, so things are just going to keep popping bigger and bigger.
Right, right. Well, I didn't know you was in that movie, The Trap. I didn't even know that. I got to go back and check that out. Look for you in there, because I've seen that on Netflix. I watched it, but I didn't really watch it. I got to go back and check that out. Y'all go check out that movie, The Trap. It's on Netflix. Check my girl Tiffany out. She's out there. Netflix and chill, and watch that tonight if you get a chance. I know I am. So congratulations on that. How about music, Tiff? I never know you to, you know, step in the booth. I know you probably got some bars that the world hasn't heard. Can we expect any music ever coming from Miss Simmons?
Well, you know what? To be honest with you, you never know, because I am a writer. I write a lot of poetry that I would love to convert into songs to sell them, you know, and have some publishing checks coming in that way. So you know, you never know. I played around a little bit in the booth, but I want to do a song, and I want to really put in the effort so it's a dope song. I'm not saying I'm trying to be, you know, a rapper or the next big star, any of that, but I'm a person that entertains. I love entertainment, so it's just a part of me being creative. So, yeah, you'll see at least one song out here from the Plugs Lawyer one of these days. But
yeah, we need
sure
that mixtape.
Out here. I
might do it. No. Right. And some more of your things that you've done. Let's talk about the book. We know that you have a book or two out there. Speak about your writing career as well, because you're successful in that area. And can we expect any more books coming from Ms.
Yes.
Simmons?
I do write. I'm a four-time author. The fifth and sixth book will be coming out soon. The book that is, you know, well-known is called The Plugged Lawyer. It's a fiction book, the trap novel, and it's kind of based on a young girl like myself, a good girl with trap habits that grows up to become, you know, a great attorney. So that story I kind of pride myself on, because less than 3% of black women become attorneys. So, you know, to create something that will inspire the next generation, that is powerful. I mean, if you look,
right.
I don't know if you saw on Instagram the other day, but it was like a little girl was getting her hair done, and she had said to the camera, "No, I'm ugly." And the hairdresser was like, "No, you're not ugly. You're pretty. You're black. You're beautiful. You're going to be great in life." And she just spoke life into that little girl, and that little girl was crying, but she received it. So just to see the impact that one person had on a little girl to make her feel good about herself, imagine all the little girls reading that book or seeing the movie The Plugged Lawyer, or even the young men seeing a black powerful woman that look like them, that act like them on the screen. That's going to change some generations. So I just have to keep going, keep creating, keep trusting, you know, God to provide the way.
Right, right. And you know what I would love to see from
you?
No, I didn't. I'm going to have to go back.
I'm going to have to tag you in it. That little girl, she was getting her hair done, and when she said it broke your heart, because it's like, where did you get this from? Who told you were ugly? And that's what the girl told her, the hairdresser. She's like, "No, that's, you're not ugly." And she just, you know, spoke a lot of life into that baby girl, and it was a good thing. So, yeah, if I find it again, it was on the Shade Room or something. If I find it, I'll tag you and show you. But, that was some powerful stuff. You know, to see that little girl, and just to see her receive, you know, someone speaking life into her. And then, like, they did an update video. Actually, here it is. I found it. I'm going to tag you, and I'm going to send it to you on IG. But they did an update, and the little girl, you know, she's smiling and stuff. And she's repeating, "I'm black and beautiful." So we got to teach our kids, even our young. You know, I mess with the guys a lot, because it's a lot of guys that follow me. Even with y'all, you know, you got to know your worth. You have to know yourself. You have to put in the self-worth so you have inner beauty as well. Women want more than just your money. Real women want more than just your money. You know what I'm saying? We want you to have a good heart. We want you to take care of yourself.
Right.
I
want to speak some more about that, since you spoke about the kids. What do you think, like, people can do more to encourage or just show the kids a better way? Because, you know, like, right now it's really hard. You know, these kids, this generation is really, not all of them, you know, are just, like, troubled youth, or just, you know, it's not really much positive, you know, people telling them positive things to help them grow better, because you got like the most of the entertainers or the rappers or whoever that you see what they do and what they rap about and all these things, and not all of them, but you see the kids emulate this. You know, I'm sure you see a lot of kids when you're out there, how they're being raised and how they act, and the things that's just going on with these kids. And you spoke about trying to be more positive and show the kids a better way. So how do you think we all can do that better than we're doing now?
I think it just all it all boils down to just putting in the effort. Kids just need effort. Kids just need real unconditional love. You don't have to be perfect to be involved in a kid's life, in anybody's life. You don't have to be perfect. You just have to be real. You just have to be consistent. And, you know, for one thing for me is I look at the things that I wish I had as a young girl or a young kid. You know, I'll give you a real life story. Recently, a young kid that is very close in my life tried to commit suicide. And to give your audience a little bit of background on myself, I was probably about 16 years old when I told my mom I wanted to kill myself. And, you know, the outcome of that situation, of course, I'm still here. I had a mother who wasn't equipped to even help me or love me through that. I mean, real talk, my mom handed me the pills and was like, do it. Now, because of the situation I went through, I was able to speak life into the young person in my life who tried to commit suicide. And once I told her my story, she was like, oh, my gosh, I never would imagine. I didn't know that. I didn't think that, you know, you would have experienced that. But, yeah, life is real for me, too. So, you know, to give you a real life, I guess, answer to that is that it's imperative that we speak and interact and put time into our kids because they need to know. Right. And even if you're not perfect, even if you are a person that have experienced things like myself where I didn't want to be here or whatever it is, if you're still here every single day, you still got a story to tell. You still got somebody to save. You still have purpose here. And, you know, the more you know your purpose, the more you happier with the time that you have here. People say, you know, you only live once. You live every single day you wake up. You die once.
Mm-hmm. Right. Wow. That's deep right there. Tiff, being that, like you just spoke on some things that went on in your childhood, 16, and almost wanting to kill yourself. But you, like you said, you're still here, and you just move forward through that and just, you know, because like you said, everybody has things going on that we don't know. Nobody's perfect. I want to ask you, and maybe this will help somebody else listening or a young lady, what helped you, you know, because you said it wasn't your mother, what made you or helped you push through those times and be stronger for yourself and get through it and, you know, go to college like you did and get through college and do all the things you did, go to law school, become a lawyer, you know, when you had these obstacles in your life, well, I'm sure obviously the family home wasn't what you wanted it to be and even your mother, you know, what made you or what helped you push through all of that and still overcome all those obstacles when it could have been easy for you to just, you know, do something else, fuck it, you know, give up, you know, and not push as hard as you did and still do.
People say it's easy to give up, but it wasn't easy for me to give up. I had so many things inside of me that I knew I needed to accomplish. And, you know, to be real with you, sure, niggas like me, we fall out the sky. You don't just bump into niggas like me. So that's just what it is. Oh, for real, that's just what it is.
Right, right, right. Wow. And like I said, I think all those things just made you a strong, like, woman because you're very strong, you know, like you said, you're confident in yourself, you're independent, you know, you just do all these things and keep the drive and you do it, like I said, you have a team, but, you know, you push you, you know, I don't see nobody, you know, with you, it's you pushing you and believing in yourself, you know what I mean? I think that's very powerful, and I think that's what, you know, young ladies need to follow. You know, the things that you do because you're very, you're like an inspiration, you know, to people that see the things you do because you keep it going, you keep it moving, and it's always positive, good energy, smiling all the time, never negativity and bullshit. So I think that's very powerful and positive of the things that you do. I wanted to ask you, I would love to see maybe some type of, I wouldn't say a movie, but like some type of story, documentary about your life and about the things you do. I think that would be very powerful and, you know, give people the chance to look inside your life because we see it on the Instagram and the shows and the things you do, but to really see it like in some type of documentary or something, I think that would be dope right there.
Yeah, it's coming. It's coming.
Okay.
It's coming. Okay. And if any of your listeners are videographers and they want to, you know, gift me with the documentary, they could definitely do so. Tell them to hit me up at Official Simmons Law on IG if they want to work with me. Holler at me.
Right. Okay. You heard that, people. Holler at her. Follow her at Official Simmons Law Instagram, the plug's lawyer. She's there. She's everywhere. Who are some of the people that inspire you, Tiffany, if there's any, whether it be a lawyer or I mean, anybody, you know, a regular person? Who are some of the people that inspire you or that you give credit to that maybe did help you or did said something, put some game, you know, whatever that helps you in life that you can, you know, speak on?
There's a lot of people that that inspire me. Honestly, I'm a person that likes documentaries. So I look at a lot of the documentaries on some of our old entertainers. For example, if you look on our Simmons Law Instagram page, we just posted about Hazel Scott. Hazel Scott, she was an entertainer. She was a musician. She was also an actress. And guess what? She was the first Black American that hosted her own TV show. And that was 3 decades before Oprah. So imagine that. So looking at people like that,
wow.
Looking at people like Lena Horne, looking at people, you know, even up to date like Taraji Henson, looking at 50 Cent. I've listened to a lot of stories. I read a lot of books. People that made something out of nothing, that's what I respect. That's what I look at. That's what I learn from, because that's the cloth that I'm cut from. You know, you say
right.
Or you see that I go hard for my name because that's just what it is. Why not fucking go hard for my own name? I'm a Simmons. Why not
right.
go hard? My name means something. So, you know, those are the type of people that inspire me. And as of late, those are the things I've been looking at. I've been looking at, you know, the Jimi Hendrix documentary. If you look at... Gosh, what is his name? He was the first Black NASCAR race driver. I believe his name was Willie Davis. It's Willie, but I can't.
Wow.
I think his last name is Davis. But I just watched his documentary on Netflix. I mean, the Netflix documentary is called Uppity, because they used to call him Uppity Nigga. And imagine
okay.
doing the thing that you loved since you was a kid. But you still being called a nigga. You still being told you're not in the right place. That's the same shit that I get as the lawyer. That's the same thing that I get sometimes, even as the entertainer or the pretty girl. So the things that we experience as minorities, as Black people, the adversities, this shit ain't nothing new. But if you know your
right.
history, if you listen, if you read, if you learn stuff outside of being handheld, then you will know. A lot of people, they going
right.
to be lost in the sauce because they don't read shit. They looking for the cliff notes. They looking for somebody to feed them all the time. Sometimes you got to go feed yourself. Sometimes you got to go fish,
right.
cut the fish up, cook that bitch yourself. And a lot of people don't know how to do that. That's why it's a lot of lost people out here.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, fishing. I haven't fished in a long time. I used to go when I was little, but never anymore. That's like, I have a homeboy that likes to fish. He says it gives you really like peace of mind. You know,
it does.
That's a
it
great
does.
Hobby.
My granddad, he lived until he was 90, so he fished until damn near he died. And that's where I myself, my brother cousins, my sister cousins, we did that with my granddad. We did that with my dad. That was good family time. People need to get back to, you know, again, the things that connect you to other people, which is stuff
right,
like that.
Right. Right. I want to bring up Queen Gina, which is my co-host on the show. She wanted to speak to you and add something, if you don't mind,
okay.
Tiff.
Okay. How you
Queen
doing?
Gina. Fine. How you doing, Queen
Hi,
Tiffany?
Queen
how are you? Hey,
I
follow you. Great, I follow
okay.
you on Instagram. Very inspirational. I see your outings and your workout and everything. So keep doing your thing. Thank you. Listen, I wanted to piggyback. I did see the video of the little princess who was crying. It was very heartbreaking. Very heartbreaking. And also, I have a granddaughter who's 9 years old now, and she's mixed, and she has a lot of hair, and she gets teased a lot at school by the way that she looks. So I told her 2 weeks ago to repeat this to herself every morning before going to school, and she has to repeat it to the children at school. Tell them, I'm beautiful from my head to my toes to the depth of my soul. I am beautiful.
Yes.
So you, yes, you do have to encourage these other young people. I had a daycare for 10 years, and it was the best part, one of the best things in my life, teaching the children. And, you know, I taught the girls the etiquette about everything, because I had girls in there and some boys, but more girls. So I taught them that as well. So what you were saying about being in the lives of our children is important. It's very important. And I hope some of the listeners are listening and can also take this and encourage their children, grandchildren, even children that they don't know. If you see a little girl, tell her she's beautiful. If you see a little boy, tell him he's handsome, because they need that, because a lot of times they aren't getting this from home. They aren't getting it from anybody, actually. So obviously the little girl who felt like she was ugly, because when she turned around and hugged her hairdresser, when she told her, oh, no, you're beautiful, that was the most heartbreaking thing that I could have seen. So I didn't see that.
And I personally, you know, to be real with you, I have not experienced the you're ugly, but I was the little girl, I was the young woman who felt I was not worthy. So although I have always heard you're pretty, you're pretty, you're pretty since I was a little girl, I was, like I told you all earlier, I was doing modeling pictures since I was a baby. So the pretty thing wasn't it for me. I had to deal with feeling unworthy because I was the five-year-old that was assaulted by a relative and nobody did anything. So that was my story that I had to, you know, work through, of the feeling of I'm not worth anything. Yeah, I'm pretty. Yeah, y'all looking at me. Yeah, every day I hear this. So I grew up hiding myself. I wore baggy clothes. Now, of course, I grew up in a time where the baggy clothes was popular, but I didn't want that sort of attention. So, you know, we live in a time where young ladies are yearning for attention and doing certain things on social media, where when I was growing up, I already got that attention. So I didn't want that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So,
we
have to. So I wrap that up to say we have to speak life, whether it is from a perspective of I'm ugly on the outside or I'm ugly on the inside. We have to speak life into each other.
Yes, yes, yes. So, yeah, blessings to everything you're doing. I'm going to watch the movie after we get off the show. I'm going to definitely, I already done pulled it up, so I got it on pause, and I'm going to check it out, because I've seen it.
I'm in there a couple times. Yeah, I'm in there a couple times. I have on a red tank top. One of the times I'm in the line to get some chicken from the chicken spot. So that's the part I'm in. And you definitely see me because I'm in the screen with when Mike X is in there a few times. So, yeah.
Well, I'm sure I would have noticed you because you're beautiful and you stand out. So, I'm sure I would have said, okay, there she go right there.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome. So, blessings to you. Have a wonderful week. Sending you positive energy for the beginning of next week. And don't forget to turn your clock back tonight. We lose an hour.
Is tonight?
Yes, tonight. Mm. We lose an hour.
Okay.
We got to go back. Yeah. And
okay.
I also like what you said about, because I believe in that too.
A forward. We
die
go
every
forward,
night.
No, it's spring forward. Fall back. No,
okay.
It's spring forward and fall back.
Okay, well,
okay,
we do something. Okay. Something's going on with the time.
We lose an hour, so that shit is going up. Yeah.
Okay, well,
right.
Well, look, something's happening. Let's just not forget to do it. G-Lew, because we do have a show tomorrow. We don't want to be tardy for the party,
right.
So.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Hey, have a great one.
All right.
Thank you,
Queen.
You're welcome.
Hey, Tiffany, again, speaking about this, entertainment field, movies and things that you're doing, what do you think about that industry, like the little bit that you get to see when you're on set or when you deal with people or see, you know, I'm sure you know other actors and people in that field. What do you think about that industry? Because it's a lot of, I've heard good and bad about it. You know, what do you think about it from your experiences? And would that be something you want to do more? You know, I'm sure you do. What do you think about it?
In any industry, it's good and bad. So, you know, I treat it like I treat the legal industry. I treat it like I treat the business industry. It's just business for me. I do what I need to do as the actress, as the model. And, you know, in the words of Trouble, the rapper, I stack, pray, and stay out the way. That's just what it is.
That's right. And how you deal with these, we kind of spoke about it before, and I'm sure you deal with it the way you deal with it because you're Tiffany. But, you know, for the people listening, how do you deal with, you know, these people in the industry, these Wolfs and these Harvey Weinsteins and, you know, people that you know, do business with you or try to, you know, do other business with you or be, you know, all this shit I'm sure you've seen a million times. How do you deal with that part of it, being that you're a female in this industry?
It's interesting you brought up the name Harvey Weinstein because that was one of the cases we talked about on Law and Crime last, his conviction, and now he's awaiting sentencing for being convicted of rape in the third degree. Now, how do I feel about people like that in life or in any industry? I feel like they're cowards. I mean, my first experience, as you heard, and I can speak candid about it now because I'm healed, but my first experience with a Harvey Weinstein was in my own fucking family at 5 years old. So, you know, this happens more often than not, especially for women, especially for attractive women, especially for women in industries that are male dominated. And the only thing that I can say is women, protect yourself. Women, know yourself. And what I mean by knowing yourself, that means by knowing yourself, investing the time into you emotionally so you're emotionally whole, physically whole, going to the gym, whatever it is. So, for example, if someone brings that type of energy to you, you're in a good emotional space to be able to respond to that in a manner that keeps you safe instead of reacting. Because of what happened to me as a young kid, I lived a life of really, you know, reacting to things based on the trauma that I experienced. As I grew, as I invested in myself through therapy, be it through it, you know, whatever, self-love, whatever I needed to do to fix me, that's when you attract different energy, you attract different people. So in 2020, it's not going to be a Harvey Weinstein situation or person around me, period, because my energy is that good, that pure, that purpose-filled that they not going to have a chance to come around me, period. You know, they ain't even, you know, that type of vibe is not going to be in my circle. So, you know, that's what I would say to people that's out there. Unfortunately, it's crazy people everywhere. It's you know, people that mean you no good that's laying right next to you. You never know. But that's why I implore, you know, everybody, men and women, to know yourself. Invest in yourself. Watch the situations you've been in. Hell, I had situations that I've been in college where, you know, people have taken advantage of me, again, because it's just, you could be naive, you could be whatever it is. But those sorts of situations, they happen, they can either make or break you. And I've try to do the best of letting those make me better and not break me.
Right. And I got you. And one more thing, speaking kind of on that, since you're a lawyer, you know, we have like the Me Too movement and all these things. Would that be like a case you would take on for somebody, a female or something, that like a Me Too thing where they wanted to, you know, do something like that, like against the Harvey Weinstein or anybody that may have taken advantage of them, how this Me Too thing is going on?
The Me Too thing is not anything new. I mean, especially in the black community. I mean, if you look at history, I'm going to take it back to the realest thing one of my grandmothers told me, before she passed. Now, I expressed to her the situation within my own family with me. And one of the things she said was, that happened to me too. But we didn't talk about that because that was shameful. So for the black community, that has been going on for a long, long time. Hell, you look back to slavery days where men and women were both raped and molested in front of their families, in front of communities of other black people. So to kind of answer your question, I don't see that Me Too experience as a movement that I am specifically going to take on or just because a man or a woman came to me with that. However, there are cases that I have currently pending that deal with situations like that. I've had situations in the past where a male client was accused of something that he didn't do. The current case that I have going on is male clients that that were not properly protected at their university in situations like this. So, if the case presents itself to me and I feel like the client or the matter is a cause that is for Simmons Law, then I'll take it on. But I'm not going to necessarily say just because this was a Me Too or whatever, I'm going to take this. Because everything, every cause out there is not my, that's not my battle. That's not my mission. That's not my goal, if that makes sense.
Right. Yeah, I got you. Hold up, switching lanes right quick. I want to ask you about this. This just came to my attention, but it happened a couple of days ago, I believe it was in Alabama, where the guy was executed, and it was a lot of talk. I didn't really even know much about this until it happened, but they say he was executed, and they knew he was innocent or whatever the case. What's your take on that case, if you have any?
Well,
I didn't know much about it.
His name was Nathaniel. I didn't know a lot about it either until I saw the people trying to help, get him pardoned or get his execution stayed. What I do know is his stay was his execution was stayed, and what that means is that it stopped. Stayed means, they won't.
Right.
So his execution was stayed by the Supreme Court. However, the governor of Alabama, who is elected, so if you have Alabama listeners, tell them to elect a better governor. But the governor who is elected, she lifted the stay. So the man, Nathaniel, he ended up being murdered. And from my understanding with his case, he was accused of being involved with a police murder, a murder of three police officers, which he didn't do, and the people that actually did the murder are still alive in jail. Now, to wrap up, and answer, my thoughts on it is, they doing what the so-called justice system was designed to do, and it wasn't here for us. It's unfortunate. My prayers, and I wish and send light and love to his family. But I feel the governor who lifted the stay is disgusting. And the people of Alabama, they need to vote her out expeditiously, in my TI voice.
Well, how can that happen, though? Is there an election coming up, or how can someone be voted out or put out of their position? Can that happen?
We are in election season. Yes, she can be voted out. So what people need to do is vote, rain, sleet, or snow. Watch this voting cycle. Watch the elections. Watch the weather. If the weather is fucked up, still go out and vote. People want to talk about, they're doing stuff to affect climate change, or they're doing this, or they're rigging elections. Yeah, they're doing a whole lot of stuff. But we all got to remember, if everybody is doing their part, it might be a little, it might be a lot, but just do your little part. And all those little parts are going to add up. Like somebody just posted the other day, Can all of my, you know, million friends on IG give a dollar to this organization? Imagine if each person actually gave that dollar, that organization had a million. It's just that simple. $1. So I gave the $1, and that just put them one step further to their mission. So just use that as the example. $1 in your life might be to repost somebody's video. $1 in your life might be to take your niece to the movies or your nephew to the movies or pick up your kids so your baby mama don't have to pick them up from school. Whatever it is, your $1 is there, and it's all it takes for you to do it, you know?
Right. One more thing about this political, since we're speaking political briefly. What's your take on the upcoming election what's going on with these Democrats, and we know who's the Republican, Donald Trump, our president. What do you think about this upcoming election and the candidates that we have on the Democratic side, if you're Democrat or Republican?
Well, I don't think anything, honestly. I haven't really looked at any of the candidates. Donald Trump is not my president, so, you know, like I said, I'm doing the things within my community, my circle, my tribe to strengthen what's around me. People are looking at the top and pointing fingers and being distracted and thinking that, you know, no, do what you can do within your community to promote change, to bring change. For example, Nathaniel Woods, he wouldn't have been murdered by the state of Alabama had those folks not voted her in. So, to be honest with you, fuck all that stuff at the national level. If you cannot invest into your local community first and build up your local community, hell, build up your household.
Yeah.
So, for me, I'm not really concerned with what Donald Trump is doing at all.
Okay.
I'm tapped into what my purpose is and what I can do on this earth.
Right.
It's spring forward. To tell your viewers or your listeners on the podcast, it's spring forward. So don't forget to set your clock forward for daylight savings time, y'all.
That part. And, Tiff, hold on. One more thing about that, because you spoke about the community, and it's more important, I think, as voters this year when they go out and vote, to look more into the locally candidates and people in the areas that can affect your community immediately, you know what I mean, as opposed to the presidential thing, because you just spoke about that. How can even me, myself, I want to know, how can you get more involved or see what's going on in your communities or just the local kind of thing to vote the right people, or governors and senators to vote the right people in to have an effect on the what's going on more around you opposed to the national level? Because a lot of people don't know that. When you go to the polls sometimes, you don't even know some of these people who they are. Maybe you just may vote because it's Democrat, you know. So how do people go about more finding out more about their immediate communities and the people they need to help vote in or not vote in?
They can find out by getting involved in their community. Google stuff online while it's still free. Google is free. Do your own research. I mean, I'm not a politician right now, Lou, so I can't, you know, specifically tell people what website to go to. I'm just a hood chick that just happened to be a lawyer. But
okay.
You know, people, the best way I would say get involved, like I say, is just Google. Google is your friend. Look for the information. Information is there if you want it. And get involved in your local politics.
Right. And tell us if you want to, because you do a lot. I see you doing a lot in the communities and abroad, everywhere. You know, tell us some of the community work you do or some of the things you do to help out, you know, some of the things that people may not know.
Well, we're always doing stuff in the community, giving back. We do food drives. We volunteer with other organizations. As of right now, we don't have any events coming up, but one of the things that I am working on is a project called The Love School, which is my own nonprofit, which is basically going to be the home of love, and just encompassing the things that I do out of love. meaning, you know, visiting people in the hospital that have cancer, meaning giving clothes for the food drive, giving dresses for high school proms, whatever it is that I do to invest into our next generation or our community, it's now going to be going through my nonprofit called The Love School. We started a cartoon, so if you're into cartoons and anime and things like that, we have a black cartoon kid lawyer. It's called Tiffany and the Love School Stories. The Love School Stories on IG. You can see it on our YouTube channel, which I thought was pretty dope because our kids can see something that looks like them that's giving little life lessons, some of it related to legal, but coming from a place of love. And the dope thing about our cartoon is I am using an 11-year-old black girl named Jayla. She's the artist that helped create the cartoon. So check out The Love School Stories. That's my kid cartoon that's out. That's, like I say, another way of inspiring the next generation and planting that seed for our next lawyers.
Mm. Wow. Go check that out. The name again, Tiff, and where can they find it?
The Love School Stories, that is actually available on our Instagram page. They can watch the cartoons on there. We put up the short episode one, and that's just the intro episode of The Love School and the character Tiffany, the kid lawyer. And then we'll be putting our second episode up soon. You can also see it on the YouTube channel, the Tiffany Simmons YouTube channel. We have the stories up on there. But like I say, it's a pretty dope thing. It's made by a young black girl. So if you want to support myself, support our next generation of cartoonists, you might see it on, you know, I don't know, Cartoon Network, Adult Swim one day.
Right. That's what's up. That's what's up. Tiffany Simmons. Hey, Tiff, it's like you've been doing work all week. It's Saturday night. You just got back from New York. You're back in the A. What's Tiffany doing to wind down tonight?
Well, tonight it's all good. Tonight I actually am going to a party tonight, a masked ball for, you know what, I'm not even hearing makeup shit. But basically, I'm supposed to party tonight and look cute doing it in my dress. So I'm kind of excited for the party tonight. I'm going to a party that's going to benefit charity.
Okay, for a good cause. You can have fun for a good cause and act up. I'm looking forward to seeing this outfit. I'm sure you'll post it on your page and all that right there. Again, tell the people where they can follow you at and follow the story and everything about Tiffany Simmons and the law firm.
Yeah, of course. They can follow the law firm on IG at Official Simmons Law. They can follow us on our YouTube channel, Tiffany Simmons on YouTube. Subscribe to us, like the videos, comment. I'll talk back with you. Just join the movement. You can also follow me, the brand, The Plugs Lawyer, on Instagram. If you like my acting and modeling, you can follow The Pretty Bully on Instagram. If you are a person that wants to get down with the cartoon, the kid-friendly cartoon, because I was told that our kids want to see some black cartoons, so I created one, The Love School Stories. That is on Instagram. And if you need the best lawyer in the motherfucking world, just follow me, call me. The office is 404-461-8422. Let's see what the year 2020 brings from the world of personal injury. We coming at you. We coming at all the insurance companies. We coming at you to get the best settlements for our clients. So holler at your girl.
That part. And also, Tiffany, let me say this. It's a lot of people that follow you and probably, you know, like you and all that. A lot of dudes in my inbox and all this, when they found out you're going to be on the show, they were happy, you know. So a lot of people like you probably and all that, probably men and women. So what do you want to say to your fans out there that listen to you tonight or just want to check in and check you out, you know, because she is single, y'all. You know what I mean? She She's a hard catch, though, but she's single, so I don't know. You may have a one-in-a-million shot like the lottery, man, so I'm just trying to help y'all out. But
right.
Talk to your fans out
you
there,
you motherfucking Tiffany. Right. I mean, you motherfucking right. Like I said, you know, if I fall out the sky on you, you know, that's a million-dollar shot. You know, it is like the lottery. So to the fans, male and female, I said the other day, it's funny you say that. I posted, I want a girlfriend and a boyfriend. I can't decide. But to the fans out there, no, thank you for following. Thank you for supporting. Like I say, just, you know, enjoy your life. Live your life. Every day you get a chance to wake up is a chance to do something big. It's only one you out there. I always tell people that. I mean, people say, you know, Tiffany, you so real, you so dope, or, you know, and I can't believe you a lawyer. Nobody is going to fucking box me in. If God blessed me to do a million and one things, I'm going to do those million and one things if I get a chance every single day he allows me to wake up. Because there could have been a day I said, no, I didn't want to be here and not be here anymore. So I'm grateful to be here. I'm grateful to be your lawyer, bae. I'm grateful to be your boyfriend's favorite lawyer, your girlfriend's favorite lawyer. Holler at your girl.
Tiffany Simmons. Hey, Tiff, hold on. I'm going to take one more call if somebody wants to say hi to you again. You got fans out there, I told you. But let me take a call before you leave. Caller, hello.
Hello, hello, hello. What's going on?
Yay, yay.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, yeah, hey, what's going on, Tiffany? This is Westside CC Snow. Just want to tune in and give you your props and just, you know, big hail to you because you're doing your thing. You know, I think that's big,
okay.
big.
All right, well, thanks for calling me in. Thank you for listening.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I had to listen. You know what I'm saying? I always listen to the G-Lew Show because you just made the plug, that's all.
Okay. All right. So you're gonna be sure to follow me on Instagram, on the Facebook, on the Twitter, and all of that.
Yeah, I'm already following you on Instagram.
He already following. They can say he already following.
Okay.
He already following you, girl.
All right. Well, I appreciate you fucking with the campaign.
Oh yeah. You know I'm fucking with you. You got me in the camp. Don't even trip.
All right. Well, I love it. Well, be sure to tune in. I don't know if I'm going to have it this Sunday night, but when we have our Instagram After Dark talk with Tiffany on Sundays at 11 p.m. Eastern, make sure you tune in because a lot of people, the crazy thing is people ask me all the time, hey, Tiffany, I got a quick question for you. I get that all day. So your quick question is one of a million quick questions. And when I allow people into my space where you could ask those questions for free and not for $4.50 an hour, you better pull up. And you know, we've been getting, that's what I meant to tell the viewers. No, I'm dead ass. We've been getting actually a lot of people checking us out. The first week we had, let's say, about 30 people viewing in. The next week that doubled. The next week that tripled. Then this past week it went up. And it stayed, you know, level or whatever. So we're definitely getting an audience that's tuning in. But that is the time that y'all can check out me, myself, in the comfort of my own home and get some real legal advice for the free.
Hey,
cause shit, if you call my office, you're going to pay.
Said Instagram After Dark, though. So that sounds like you could do a whole lot, you know what I mean, besides legal shit. That's Instagram After Dark.
Oh, yeah,
Okay.
It's not just law. I mean, like I say, if I'm inviting you into my space, in my home, and we kick it, like I let people be on live with me, we talk shit, we shoot the shit, we talk about a lot of stuff. I mean, hell, we did it Valentine's weekend. That was a funny show because I'm asking people what they did for Valentine's Day. Shit. Everybody's Valentine's Day is fucked up.
Damn.
So, you know, we talk about a lot of different stuff. It's not all legal, but it is a platform where if you have a legal, if you have a legal question that you want to ask, you can ask it on that platform.
Okay. Hey, Tiffany, is there any way you can go back and see the pad? I know that's on Instagram Live, so I don't know if they saved the videos. Is there any way you can go back and look at some of the previous episodes you did?
Hold on. That's my phone, y'all. I got to switch out the battery. The Instagram Live stays for 24 hours, but then it deletes. So those, you can't watch those. But the videos that I post of tips, of legal tips, of what you need to do if you're pulled over, which is shut the fuck up, tell them your name and address only, and tell them to call your lawyer if you are being detained. Those are three tips right there. We have videos like that all on our YouTube channel. So, you know, there's information out there, and we'll do our best to kind of, you know, keep the IG After Dark going, because there's a lot of people that's checking in, you know, that just want to see, you know, see what it's like. What's the plan?
They just want to see you. They want to see you. Keep it real. They want to see
you.
Okay. Big Snow, what up, man? You got anything else for Tiff?
No, man, I just want to say y'all having a good show. Much love to both y'all, and, you know, do your thing. I'll see you at the Cali Picnic, though, if I don't see you next week.
Oh, yeah, the Cali Picnic. Tiff, you pulling up this year? You told me last year you was about to. This year we need you to pull up.
Okay, well, you need to send me the info. I need to have a table. The
okay.
plug lawyer need a table, a booth.
Okay,
I'm
for sure, for sure, for
so,
sure,
yeah,
for sure.
Send me the info.
Say less. Okay, I got you. Yeah, I meant to add. I'm glad you brought that up, Snow. Hey, well, good looking, Snow. Much love.
All right.
My
nil.
Keep
going on. Thanks. Big props, Tiff. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yay, yay.
So, yay, yay. Westside Car Club, Snow Brizzle. Hey, Tiffany, you know, I want to hold you all night. I know you got your thing to do and all that. I want you to get ready, get pretty and all that. But before we go, what do you want to leave the people with about Tiffany? Maybe that we didn't speak about tonight, you wanted to speak about anything, or just that you want to leave the people with on this podcast before we depart, that they could take with them from you, or this conversation, you know, that you want the people to have?
One thing I do want the people to take from the podcast is, you know, allow people to be who they are. For example, sometimes people get so caught up on just the fact that I'm a lawyer that they forget that I'm human, that I'm woman, that I'm a black woman, that I do other things outside of that, that I'm also an author, an actor, model. You know, I'm a sister. I'm somebody's daughter. I'm a lover. I'm a friend. So, you know, I say all of those things to say, don't be afraid to be you. Don't be afraid to live your purpose. Don't be afraid to love. And that includes loving yourself. You know, I joke around. You know, I kid around. I have a high following that is males. So I'm going to speak to my males on this. Don't be afraid to love yourself. Don't be afraid to take care of yourself. And that may mean you leaving situations that's not best for you. That may mean you leaving jobs that's not best for you. That may mean you investing into your emotional health, your mental health. Like, it's 2020. Time out for that, you know, who's the girl that's going to stay down through all my shit. No, handle your baggage. And that goes for women, too. Handle your baggage as well. Handle your baggage so you whole people can connect with other whole people, because we have to, in 2020, connect and support and unite. Imagine how much stuff we can get accomplished when we do that. So, and it all starts with you. It starts with us. I wouldn't be here, you know, speaking with you, saying this real nigga shit, but still being myself if I didn't invest into Tiffany, the person. I wouldn't be able to be the undefeated attorney if I didn't take the time to invest in that. And just remember, if God brought you to it, he's going to bring you through it. So y'all just keep your head up, living, keep laughing, keep loving, and enjoying your shit. And sometimes love means beating somebody ass, too. So don't get it twisted. Everything ain't just peaches and cream when I say love. But I do mean love. But people need to know that it's many parts of love, too.
That part. The lovely Miss Tiffany Simmons, Simmons Law. Tiffany, thank you for blessing us on this podcast, episode 11, the G-Lew Show Podcast. It was a great episode. It was an honor. Always a pleasure. You know, much success and everything to you. You know, I'm proud of you. This is my girl, Tiffany. We go back 20 plus years, you know, and I always tell her I'm proud of her. You know, she knows that already. But just thank you again for joining the podcast and always giving us love over here at the G-Lew Show. We really appreciate it and got much love for you. Keep on doing your thing, mama.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. Y'all have a good one. Bye.
All right, Tiff. Peace and love. Hey, that's episode 11 of the G-Lew Show podcast, man. It was another great episode, man. We've been doing it for the women lately. We got a lot of great episodes with the females on here. As you heard, Queen Jean, she was on our first episode. We got Dee Dee Harrison. We got Mama Boo. We had Tiffany just now. We had the homegirl Jackie Ray Phillips last week. So we repping for the ladies. Also had the homegirl Sparky D on the G-Lew Show. So just keep up with what we're doing. This is episode 11. Go back and check all the previous episodes, man. They're on Spotify, Apple, everywhere your favorite podcasts are at. We there, too. So look up the G-Lew Show. Show us some love. You know, shout out to Queen Jean. Check us out on G-Lew Show Wednesdays, Fridays, and Sundays tomorrow. OG Sundays, number one show on Blog Talk Radio and abroad. Queen Jean is with me. Before we go, I got to bring Queen in. Tell them about it, Queen. Take us out of here.
Oh, yeah, check us out on our Westside Wednesdays, our Fabulous Fridays, and our number one rated show, our OG Fabulous Lowrider OG show. That's our kickback, relaxed show where we sit up, we play oldies, we jive talk. We talk about every and anything. You can't come on this show on Sundays with a sensitive heart because sometimes my guys go hard in the paint, so... but check us out. It's definitely worth it. You can follow us on YouTube, G-Lew, the G-Lew Podcast, and Blog Talk Radio, the G-Lew Show. Check us out. And what do? We spring forward tonight.
Spring
it's already
forward.
Dark, too, outside. Yeah, we spring
yeah,
forward.
So you're going to go up an hour.
Spring forward. Yeah, we go up
yeah,
an hour.
Yeah. Yep.
And everybody just have a wonderful Saturday. You know, whatever you're going to do, you're going to get out there with your red cups, blue cups, martini glass, champagne glass, whatever you do, be safe and just have fun. I'm just going to chill and watch this show on Netflix with Miss Tiffany, see what's going on here with this movie.
Ha. That's what's up, that part.
That was a great
Alrighty.
Show.
Well, episode, thank you, Queen. Thank you, Queen. Thank you, everybody who participated. Shout out to Snow Westside Car Club, our sponsors, 93 Tweed FM, BTP Media, and OG Music. Also, check my music out, man. I'm on iTunes everywhere. 10, 11 albums, classics, man. You dig? And again, episode 11, go back and check the previous episodes. We're on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Anchor. We're on Anchor as well. And Blog Talk Radio every Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. The G-Lew Show Podcast, episode 11. Peace and love, y'all.